Hey, what's up? It's Saka here. Welcome back to my weekly blog. Last week was a holiday week called Golden Week here in Japan, and so I took some break, and I'm back this week now. And yeah, good news. So Inkdrop Mobile version 5 is finally available officially. So I'd like to talk about it and what's new in version 5 briefly, and I'd like to discuss what's next for Inkdrop. So what's new in mobile version 5? I built the mobile app completely from scratch. So I wanted to solve the big issue on Android, that is the Markdown editor is quite unstable to edit. So two years ago I tried to build a native editor on each platform, but I found that it was too hard to build it for me alone. Because the native APIs on iOS and Android are completely different, and Android is especially hard to implement using editor text component. And so I decided to go with CodeMiller version 6. And 2 years ago, CodeMiller version 6 was still in development, so it's not ready for production use. But while I was trying building a native editor, CodeMiller was also evolving as well. And last year, CodeMiller version 6 was officially released, and I tried it and found that it's stable enough for production use on both iOS and Android. So I decided to go with CodeMiller, and it works pretty fine. So I'm so happy to solve the issues on Android and iOS, like weird typing bugs when adding markup. So such as weird typing bugs when editing markup. And the can't delete line break on Android. Thanks Magnus for reporting. Yeah, so I'm so happy to be to have these problems solved. Yeah, and the next one is multiple UI theme support. So the old version supports light and dark theme, but now it has two more themes, which are Solaris Dark, which is my favorite one, and the Nord themes, which is this blue one. Yeah. So they are very beautiful, so please try it. Okay, the next one is side-by-side mode support on tablets. So the desktop version already has this feature, but mobile version hasn't yet, but now it's available. So if you have a tablet, you can switch the view mode to side by side. So you can view the editor and preview pane at the same time. So you can quickly check what your note will eventually look like while editing your note, which is cool. And next one is auto link title. So it's a small feature, but it's very useful. When you often insert links that you found on the web, the Inkdrop helps you insert link with title. So when you find an interesting article or a tweet, you can simply copy the URL and paste into the editor. Then the app automatically fetches the page title from the page and inserts a link format like this with title. So that's very useful when you do some research or things like that. And next one is find in notes. It's a So it's finally available. So you can search within the node on the editor, like this. Yeah. And this one is a revision history. This is an improvement of the revision history. So you can quickly check the what's been changed. You can quickly check the changes history with GitHub like diff view like this. So you can quickly know which lines are added, which lines are deleted, changed, and very useful. That's the main update on version 5. I hope you like it. Okay. Yes, so next one is, so yeah. And I'd like to answer a quick question from Kotsi. Thank you for the question. So he asked that, do you feel submissions to Google Play Store are easier? Actually, yes, because my app was approved on Google Play Store in just 10 minutes. And I provided a test account to review properly, but they didn't even log into Inkdrop with this test account. So I don't know what they tested my app. So it's way easier than the App Store. They have review guidelines, and that looks very strict. But so it looks like they are not reviewing the apps strictly as Apple's. So I haven't ever had any rejections on the Play Store, and so they usually approve my app within several hours. So you don't have to worry about it. Okay, and next up is so this week I've been working on migrating the web app from Flow.js to TypeScript. So my code base was written in Flow.js in the mobile app and desktop app, web app, server side code, and everything is written in Flow.js, was written in Flow.js, and I'm gradually migrating my code base to TypeScript. Then this time the mobile app has been successfully migrated to TypeScript. So I'd like to also migrate web app to TypeScript. And the code base is now 6 years old, so it's quite old. And I've been constantly updating the dependencies like React and other related packages. So this time here is the diff of the packagization. So here is the diff of package JSON. So, for example, connected React router has been deprecated, and pre-CSS is no longer maintained. So I had to replace them. And the React router was version 5, so I upgraded to 6. And after the migration, the number of dependencies significantly decreased, like so, which is great. Yeah, so I deployed it yesterday, and looks like it's working fine. Yeah, so well, let's talk about what's next for Inkdrop. Last month I had a brute force attack to the my server, and which is hard, and I added a rate limiting to the API as a quick fix. But I'd like to add a further security improvement, and the feature is two-factor authentication. As you may know, two-factor authentication can prevent your account to be breached, even if your account has been leaked. So yeah, so it'll be nice to support to the authentication as well. And I've been searching for this one is one of the long awaited features, and people have been requesting this feature. They are no longer using Inkdrop, unfortunately. Yeah, but so I'd like to start working on it. And I'm currently searching for a reliable OTP library. And here are what I checked. And I found and SpeakEasy is no longer maintained. It's the most popular one, but it's no longer maintained. And OptLib looks promising, but the last commit date is more than a year ago. So yeah, it looks like no longer maintained as well. And another one is Time2FA. It's it's new. It looks new, but it hasn't been adopted widely yet. So I don't know. It's reliable enough at the moment. And another option is email verification. So if you try to log in, Inkdrop will send you an email with a one-time passcode, so you can verify it's you. And this is very simple. So you don't have to implement time-based OTP in each client. So you can keep your project, your client project simple. That's great. So maybe I'll go with email verification solution. And the last one is Auth0. It's a popular authentication service, and they have a library for React Native, which is cool. And I looked into the package JSON and found that it requires some dependencies like Expo plugin, Expo config plugins, Base64, CryptoJS, JSBM, JWT related packages, and so on. So I personally don't feel like adding more dependencies just for TOTP. So I don't know. I'll go with Auth0. So yeah. So what do you think? There are no silver bullet. So there are always pros and cons. Like email verification is simple to implement, users have to check their email inbox. That's kind of annoying for some users, and time based one-time passcode requires a third-party authenticator app, so it's also unuseful for some users. So maybe I will go with email verification solution because I'd like to keep my clients simple as possible. So please let me know if you have any recommendations for two-factor authentication. Yes, and I will keep migrating my code base to TypeScript. So the next app is the desktop app. So it's been a while since I had been working on the new mobile version app. The mobile version is written in React Native, so that's because initially I That's because first I built the desktop app on top of Electron, which is written in JavaScript. So I wanted to share some code base between desktop and mobile. And the new mobile version is ready. And so some internal modules have been already converted to TypeScript. So the remaining code base is just the desktop core. So it will take a month or 2 months to complete migration to the migration. Yeah. So I'd like to start working on the desktop version as well. And I'd like to create another tutorial on devaslife. And that is gonna be about note taking, how I note take notes, how I take notes. Because I previously discussed the high churn rate of Inkdrop. I think this is largely because people don't know how to take notes for their coding, so they found Inkdrop and purchased it, but they don't know how to leverage note taking in Markdown. So I'd like to share. So it would be nice to share how I use Inkdrop in my real workflow. The 90% of my audience of devaslife are beginners, I think, and they want to become like me, and they want to learn how I learned to code. I already gave some talk about how I learned to code, but I haven't ever talked about note-taking. And note-taking is important for me, so that's why I built it myself. I built the app myself. So I take notes every day. And it's crucial for my daily work. So I'd like to talk about how I take notes, how I use my notes to organize my work and learn new technologies. So it'd be nice to talk about it. Yeah. I've been practicing speaking English on here, the second channel. So I feel like giving a talk on the main channel as well. Yeah, so I'll try it. Yeah, that's it. So thank you for watching, and see you in the next one. Have a productive day.